We're here today for the final part of our Treasure and Jewellery Show London competition for London Jewellery Week to win a stand. We're now in the final stage of the competition with our three winners, who are Clarice Price-Thomas, who we've got here today, Claire English and Oak Fine Jewellery. We're going to be talking about the commerciability of their brands. This is the final stage, and a number of our judges have submitted questions for the three finalists about their jewellery, and this will help us decide who wins the stand at Jewellery Show London, which will be the trade and retailer focus part of London Jewellery Week. So we're here with Clarice, who is one of our three finalists, and she has this lovely jewellery that's all inspired by kind of watchmaking, watch parts, lots of kind of influence from the hands and the cogs that are part of the jewellery. So we're going to talk a little bit more about this now. So first up, tell me a bit about your brand vision and the kind of DNA of your brand and what it's about.
I think probably that's such a hard question. Sorry.
Well, what is it about what you do that kind of sets you apart from others or is a little bit different from other jewellery?
I think the fact that I'm kind of really, really inspired by machines and kind of this element of watchmakers and clockmakers, machinery and stuff like that. So I think the finish I go for is quite kind of crisp,
yeah,
machine kind of,
yeah,
look.
Very precise. When you kind of obviously started out designing your kind of brand, is there anything that makes you, well, I guess you've got the machine aside, but kind of what makes Clarice Price-Thomas,
yeah,
what it is in, yeah, terms of like jewellery design? So you have this kind of set structure, I suppose, that makes you stand out.
Yeah.
From others, which, yeah, it's very evident. Okay, so aside from that, who would you say is kind of your typical customer, or who is the kind of typical customer that would buy your jewellery?
I'm not sure whether I'd have a typical customer. I think it's probably a range of people. I don't think my jewellery like tailors just to like a certain age group or anything like that. And the one thing that I quite like about this collection is that I think it could be quite unisex. I had a guy commission me for a solid 18 karat gold gear as an ear, just one earring. So it's kind of like, I quite like the idea that gears are quite, and gears are like, you know, this kind of machinery and gears inside of clocks and watches is probably typically quite like a manly thing. So I think it probably appeals to men, but then like in a way that, so it's kind of got like a delicate feel to it, but it's maybe, perhaps some might say it's quite like a masculine kind of subject area, so it's kind of like, you know, maybe men would quite fall there.
But by and large, it's got quite kind of wide appeal.
I think so, yeah.
Too much aimed at the 20 somethings, but likewise, you know, you could be 50 somethings.
Yeah, so. I think so, because I've kind of, you know, gone from quite a range of like smaller pieces,
lower price points
up to like higher price points. So I think I've tried to kind of cover a wide range of price points and therefore maybe age groups as well, try to get different kind of sizings and
stuff. Oh, excellent. That's good to have that variety.
Yeah.
And what kind of targets do you have for what you're doing in the next 12 months? Are there particular things or goals that you've got kind of loosely set up for where you want to take your jewellery?
I think exhibiting.
Yeah.
And you know, that allowing me to gain more stockists, just taking on my first four shop orders.
Oh, right.
For the two EC1 stores, and then I went up to Scotland and took an order from Brazen, Black Box Boutique, and
Edinburgh. Well, you've got retail stuff already, which is a good place
to
start.
I think that, you know, building on that, building on who I am and my brand, I think because I'm quite young, because I never went to uni, I think probably there's a lot that I could work on to do with my brand, consolidating it. But hopefully that will come with gaining stockists and gaining, you know, a kind of bit of a following behind me.
So do you have things, say, like a logo already for your brand? How about packaging? Have you developed some
packaging? Yeah, I've got packaging. I'm working on an online store at the moment and building.
So you're open to the e-commerce site?
I think hopefully like 3 weeks or something.
Good, okay.
Within the next month.
That's handy, that's good. And so, as you say, you've already got a couple of stockists already, and you did the competition with EC1, which obviously has developed.
Yeah.
And that's kind of helped you, I guess, build up the brand and your own design techniques. If you were talking to a retailer, what kind of key things would you pick out about what your brand is about or what your jewellery is about that is kind of a reason why they should stock you? So, what are your kind of plus points, would you say?
Probably my story, my personal story, and therefore the story of, you know, why I went into jewellery design and what I'm about, what therefore the jewellery is about. So, you know, the fact that I'm a horologist's daughter and stuff like that. I like to think also maybe I have a slight edge because I didn't study, you know, maybe that's quite interesting.
Didn't go the traditional route, did you? So you almost picked up bits and pieces from, which your father, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's what you're into, or repairer, so. Yeah, inspired by the bits and pieces that you saw.
Yeah, so I think maybe that gives me kind of a, you know, unique slant.
Yeah, it sets you apart from the normal people who may have gone to uni or to college and studied jewellery design, whereas you've done it all on off your own back.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. And if you're selling kind of directly to the public, as well as wholesaling to retailers, have you worked out your kind of pricing structures already? Kind of thinking about your entry level RRPs or your margins, like what you would kind of say is a typical markup for a retailer. Have you thought about how you're pricing?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't know any of that until I started working with Lee and Joss.
Yeah.
And obviously they have their markup, but then when I went to Scotland, you know, they have different
markups.
Everyone has slightly different. So I think, I guess what I try to do is I don't want to undercut anyone. I don't know, it's difficult.
Yeah.
No, I think that's probably something I need to think about, but I think because of perhaps the shows being in London, then I would probably try to do the average, like, London markup.
Yeah.
I think that's what would be fairest.
Oh, I think that's what you're looking about, the kind of three or isn't it?
Yeah.
That normally average about.
Yeah.
Okay, and if, say, you were working with a retailer, what kind of support or what could you offer them in terms of helping kind of increase awareness of what you do? Would you be happy to do things like events or competitions?
Definitely.
With them, if they say they want to do like an evening of new jewellery design, would you be happy to kind of take time out to go there and showcase your work?
Yeah, I think that's really important because, you know, you can't kind of give a load of work to a shop and then take the back seat and just kind of expect them to do all the work. It's, you know, it's still my work and I still want to, you know, be involved with the way it's displayed and promoted and, yeah, sold, and you know how
sharing the story.
Yeah, and I want my brand to go through the shop and through into the customer as well. So, you know, they're not just buying a piece from the shop that's just a piece of jewellery. You know, I want that to go through, to carry through. So yeah, I definitely want to be involved with that kind of area.
Good. Okay. And you've already mentioned that you're about to look your own e-commerce website. From like a practical point of view, the other kind of things that you have ready, say if you launch with a retailer, they'll often look for things like high-res images, mood shots, and obviously we're thinking about packaging. Is that all the kind of things that you have ready and good to go?
Yeah, I've had a photography shoot recently where I shot all the collection and everything, and we're having another one to kind of get some on the body and stuff like that. So yeah, I've got that.
Give a good sense of scale and things. Okay. How are you at the moment with regards to, say, turnaround? So say you had a piece that sold through particularly well, and a month later you're getting a call saying, oh, we need 20 more of, you know, one of these little rings or something.
Yeah.
How quickly are you able to turn around new kind of products?
I would like to think, because a lot of stuff, you know, I've only got a few castings, everything else is cut on the milling machine, or the gears are cut.
Okay.
So obviously that takes quite a while, but I like to think that, you know, I can rely on myself to get it done quickly rather than buying a caster.
Yeah.
Depending on if they're going to be set with stones or if they're gold plated, I would probably say 2 weeks.
2 weeks, okay.
Yeah.
Good.
Kind of feeling.
Yeah, it's probably a good level to work to. And how often are you planning on bringing out kind of new collections or developing a product line?
I would like to think probably a collection a year.
Yeah.
I'm not sure when, and I'm not sure I'd brand it as, you know, like autumn, winter, spring, summer.
Just a different.
When it's ready, I think it's important to keep like a constant. Collection, a new collection coming out every year, but I'm not sure when I'd do it. I think probably at the beginning of the year.
is where you kind of maintain the style that you have at the moment, which you use as kind of like the watch cogs and watchmaking theme, or are there other routes that you're looking to go down as well?
Other routes, but still involving machinery, but not necessarily kind of time related or gear related or anything like that. I think the next collection will be different, but I want to achieve a similar kind of finish.
Is that very high shine? Like, and with a view to say repairs, are you there on hand to say if you have any problems with chains or resizing, you're happy to do repairs for anything?
Yeah, I've got my studio now in Mount Pleasant in Hunt House, so I'm ready to kind of do anything, take orders, make new stuff, repair.
Perfect, okay. I'm on to the final couple of questions now. So, what types of PR activity have you done so far for your jewellery brand? Do you do anything online, or again with things like competitions yourself that you've kind of done to promote yourself?
Well, aside from things that I've already worn, like the Easy One thing and this, I think I've been trying to promote myself through Facebook and stuff like that. I've managed to get myself a few bits of press, but I'm hoping that when I launch my online store, then I'll be able to kind of get a bit more of momentum behind it and maybe run some kind of competition, like, to bring awareness to the site, maybe do like a percentage off or something like that to try and
just get the ball rolling.
Yeah, you can exist, but unless people know about you, you're not going to flourish. So I think that's where I'll be aiming to go. But you know, I think I've also, from winning Easy One thing, got some help from Push PR as well. So hopefully once I've got everything ready, then
just raising your name and getting people talking about what you do. Okay, excellent. And one more thing, I think just again with a view to kind of customer events and things, would you pursue things like trunk shows? So when you bring along, say, jewellery that might be things like samples that you've developed or one-off pieces, or even creating kind of special pieces for retailers to sell at customer evenings, or are you quite specific about, are you making certain kind of
I think that would be fun, it's a nice excuse to do something different and to play around with some new ideas. I think that would be really good, and again, it's direct customer interaction. I think that's really important. So if I'm able to communicate with the customers myself, and have something, have new ideas and new stuff, limited edition pieces, and I think that really adds to your brand.
What metals are you working with?
It's all solid silver with 18 karat gold
paintings,
white sapphires as well.
And are you also kind of flexible to say using 9 karat gold or 18 karat gold kind of bespoke pieces?
I've already taken orders for my engagement rings along with these designs that are solid 18 karat gold. So,
good. Okay. And if you could probably sum up your brand in 3 words, what would it be? The classic one to finish with.
Probably my brand in 3 words. I'd probably say young.
A sentence in which you kind of say, Clarice Price-Thomas jewellery is, this is this, or if you were kind of pitching it to someone who'd never seen it before and needed how you need to show them, how would you describe it?
The work or my brand?
A bit of both, I mean, your kind of work as it exists at the moment, I suppose, or what you will be showcasing, kind of at training to someone.
I guess I would probably stick with the line of, daughter of a horologist, with, oh my god, it's so hard, I hope you cut this bit out, but you really struggling
with
this.
I can edit it, it's fine.
Oh, I need to sort of, I don't know, that's really hard.
It's one of the things, someone was saying, how would you describe myself in 3 words? I was like, I have no idea.
We'll do it right back in the code. I don't know really. I'm not sure what I'd say.
Well, this is it, because it always changes, and you do always change. So.
Yeah. And I think because I haven't properly had the chance to establish myself as a brand. So it's hard to say what I am.
Before
you
move it.
Yeah.
Excellent. perfect.
Do you want to close with a thank you, anything, or are we gonna?
Thank you very much for your taking time out to come and talk to us, and wish you best of luck.
Thank you.